Welcome to the video blog. I'm Jamie Claudio, executive producer here at DS Simon Productions. And joining me today is Michael Causey. He's a writer and a consultant, and he's also a panelist on the upcoming Convergence and Communications Conference. That's happening March 28, 2014 in Arlington, Virginia. Michael, thanks so much for being with us.
Nice to be here, Jamie. Thank you.
So your panel is Native Advertising and Content in a Digital Communications World. We used to think of writing for the internet as mostly promotional or advertorial copy. How has that evolved?
I think it's evolved completely. I mean, there's been more change in the last 6 months or a year than I can remember going back 10 years. And I think a key really with writing now is the content, whether it's, we don't really use the word advertorial anymore, it's more native advertising. But it can't feel like an advertorial. It's got to be very soft sell, if it's a sell at all. You really need to position yourself as a thought leader, as someone who knows the subject well, who knows your subject matter. And I think you get kind of the reflective glory. If you're an automotive car dealer, you want people to believe you understand the industry, you understand how to make cars, you understand the economics and all the ramifications. You don't want to do some soft piece that is obviously an advertorial, that's obviously a commercial, and seems overtly biased. I think it's really important to cite things that are outside your industry, either other trade associations, government agencies, other speakers, other experts, and it lends credibility to your writing, and that's really critical now.
So you've been in public relations for about 20 years now, after a very successful career in journalism. How have you seen the writing needs of your clients change?
Well, I touched on it a little bit in the first question, but it has changed almost completely. Content is really king now, and what I mean quality content. Even more than ever, you want clarity. You want a bit of sizzle. Headlines and keywords are critical. Obviously, 10 years ago, I'm not sure keywords even mattered much, if we even knew what they were or used them. So it's an interesting combination now. You need to have some depth, but you need to have clarity. It's got to be sharp. It's got to be focused. It really has to grab people, but it has to hold them too. If you do some sort of tricky headline or something a little overly cute, you're just going to alienate your audience and do more harm than good.
So without giving away all the trade secrets, what do you find is the best approach to take when you write for your clients?
I think most clients, they're hiring you for your counsel. I think you really need to tell them straight what you think works and what doesn't work. In many, many cases, no one at the client, at their shop, really understands media strongly. Even if there's a media relations person within the company that you're working with, they've sometimes, or so inside the company, they almost forget what it's like to be on the outside and how things are perceived. So I think you've got to be not brutal, but honest, and back up what you're saying. I think it's also very important to not make it sound as if you're trying to generate work for yourself, because people really see through that. That obviously damages your reputation. But I think most clients really want to hear what you have to say. They bring you into the room for a reason. And I have found in most cases when I disagree with a client, sometimes they can talk it through to me and show me why maybe the way they need to do it is the best way. But more often than not, they'll change their mind or adapt the strategy. And I think they always appreciate the honest input.
That's really good advice. So could you please tell the audience a little bit more about the Convergence and Communications Conference?
Yeah, I think this is going to be a great event, and I thought it before I was even going to be a speaker or a participant. One of the things I really like about the event is, from looking at the roster of the speakers and then the keynote speaker, Benny Johnson, or the lunch speaker, these are people really doing it. It's not so much executive vice presidents who are a little not involved in the day-to-day so much, or they win the business, but maybe don't work it so much. I've been struck looking at the agenda and the lineup that these are the people doing it every day. I know in my panel, for example, a lot of the things I'll be talking about are clients I've been working with over the last couple of months. And in some cases, in working with some of the content partners that I work with, Washington Post, New York Times, Talking Points Memo, and others, I'll be able to bring in examples of things that I saw 2 weeks ago. So the trends are going to be very recent, and I think valuable, and that's my sense with all the other speakers. These are people really on top of it who are working these things right now. The conference is a Friday. The day before, they've been working with clients and dealing with the issues they're going to be talking about.
Well, I know we here at DS Simon Productions are very much looking forward to the upcoming conference, as well as listening to you speak as a panelist. For more information, our viewers can click on the links below, including to register. Michael, thank you so much for being with us.
My pleasure. Thank you.